I ended up turning to Islam about 3 years ago, and I was keeping it hidden from my family because I know how they feel about Muslims. And I was keeping it to myself under wraps. Everything I had was hidden. And one day my mother went through my things and found all of my things and said, "I'm not having that in my house. If you want to keep that, you got to get out of my house. If you want to stay here, you got to lose that." Yeah, when you hear somebody tell you you're going to live in a shelter, you expect an army barracks style building, big dome with cots lined up against the wall. It's not what I got at all.
ICNA Relief is the Islamic Circle of North America, and this is the relief brand specifically, in which we focus on the needs of the community. We focus on the grassroots aspects of America.
The country we live in is a great country. United States has a country of the opportunity, but at the same time, I think people are living in their bubble to think that once their life is okay, everything else is fine.
You know, we're the people that are on the ground helping people with financial assistance, with women that are in need, maybe going through domestic abuse, maybe going through other issues and need some place to lay their head down at night.
Some of them are refugees from different parts of the world, and some are locals that are women, mostly women that are going through divorces.
You know, children that, you know, go to school hungry, or they need backpacks because they don't have the necessary supplies. This is where we come in.
Some cases the masjid can handle, we always call ICNA, and they step into the plate and they do a good job at that. And there's a big increase, you know, subhanAllah, there's so many Muslim kids that are in the streets.
They are doing a wonderful job. They have been expanding their work here in home shelter programs and food pantries.
I ended up living in a regular house with a room, a kitchen and a bathroom.
And ICNA Relief work has become a tool of dawah. Like, alhamdulillah, a lot of people come to our shelter. Out of 9, 3 of them became Muslim.
And alhamdulillah, now they're back on their feet and they have jobs and they're supporting themselves.
I have personally known and I have observed them, and they have been doing it on the ground. They're doing it practically, what they are saying.
Yes, please donate. Alhamdulillah, ICNA is doing a great job, and we need more donations to help support more programs. For example, we need a shelter for brothers as well. I get so many calls from brothers have nowhere to go, and you know, so we need another shelter for brothers. We need a shelter for families with children, because so many sisters call, but they have kids that are older, especially boys, and they have nowhere to go. So they stay in the car or they stay in the street. And most of these kids, they lose their faith.
It's a double reward, really. I mean, you get paid to do what you do, but subhanAllah, the work that you do, when you see the impact that you could provide, or the impact, the way you impact a family, a Muslim family or a non-Muslim family, it's a very rewarding.
ICNA Relief has to transcend what every other relief organization is doing. Every organization comes into play to serve a need, right? If relief organizations, typically they'll come into a community, they will give some resources, they might establish a few things, and that's it. They'll stay stagnant there. They'll just keep doing that for decades and decades and decades. ICNA Relief has to transcend that. ICNA Relief has to be an organization that we start, yes, giving those basic resources, but then we work on building people.